I'm rolling, so you can...
Are you really rolling?
Yes, I took the light off.
Wheels on the bus go round and round. Sing with me, Jim. Round and round.
Square and...
Hold on a minute. Jim's having a salad right now. We're supposed to be filming a rock show, but...
Well, we're going to watch, like, movies, aren't we?
I think so. We're at the Mansfield Playhouse, for goodness sake. I mean, why else would Siskel and Ether be here on a night like tonight other than to be watching a movie at the Playhouse?
Either way, it's all good.
I'm telling you what. You have Ether kind of salad. You know what I like now? What's really good on salad? The Spectrum. You ever had
Spectrum salad?
Hey everybody, I'm Tommy Barnes, and welcome to the Mid-Ohio Rock Show. What a cool little venue we're in right now. Matter of fact, this is the official salad bar for Mansfield, Ohio.
Man, that's some good stuff.
My good buddy Jim Bush over here, he brings a baggie everywhere he goes, but the cool thing about this
bring
guy...
Bring a baggie?
Well, it's got salad in it.
It's got salad. That's what you said. That's what I told the police.
You know, everybody, you know, lettuce is lettuce, right?
Yeah, lettuce. What's that?
I think there's a few carrots in there, too. But, hey, nonetheless, so we are here at the Mansfield Playhouse hanging out with Jim Bush. And recently, about, I don't know, a while back, a video was recorded here with Jim, a brand new song he's got going. We're going to debut that for you here coming up here pretty soon. But really, truly, what we need to do is give props to Doug Wirtz and Tammy and all the staff here at the Mansfield Playhouse that allowed our producer, Ryan Nemec, to come in here with Jim.
Doug!
Exactly, and film the video we're going to be showing you here sometime. I think we're going to do it in this episode. We might wait a few episodes, but nonetheless. Where'd you get that hat, by the way?
Down at the Greek Festival.
Did you really?
Right down the street.
You know, that's coming up in May.
I never miss it.
I don't either.
Yeah, it's delicious.
It is delicious.
You ever tried their salads?
Yeah, if you like garlic, it's great.
Yeah,
man, I'm telling you, it's garlic explosion. So what was the thought... Coming down here to the Playhouse and doing a video of all the videos you've done. Why did you decide to do this?
Oh, I get two shout-outs. I get free stuff. Watch. Phil Nomov! Yeah, he's Macedonian. Close enough. Okay. Oh, excuse me?
Yeah.
Why do I do...
Why did you wake up this morning?
I have no idea. Another... It's a segue to the song, yet again, to the video, which we're not really talking about. No, we are.
Okay.
Okay. Why did we do it here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Why did we do it here? Oh, because it's great. I mean, if you could only see what we're looking at right now. Put some clothes on!
Burlesque! It expired in the 30s.
It's a beautiful theater. It looks great. Brian was a great help. Doug Wirtz is way cool. You know, they let us use it. And,
You ever had a chance to actually do any kind of play or any kind of acting where you've been on a stage like that?
Really? No, it won't happen. Anywhere. I've been about every place you can be, facility in Mansfield, and they won't keep me long anywhere.
That's why you live in Belleville?
Yeah, that's why. Yeah, Belleville. Belleville Street Fair. There you go.
Man.
There's another shout out.
You know why I go to Belleville Street Fair? Tall Timbers Wings and Lemonade.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Oh, it's excellent. Oh, lemonade. Oh, yes.
Yeah. You know they make a vodka tea that you put in lemonade? It is dynamite.
Really? Is it like a Long Island?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know, eventually on Rock Show, we're going to get back to our point of playing some music videos for you and stuff like that. But I have a lot of fun hanging out with Jim. One of the last times we did Rock Show was actually in our infancy many years ago. You were a tweener because you were at one of the teen episodes back in the day.
Really?
Yeah, so it's nice to see you've grown up a little bit since then.
Grown old a little bit.
Grown older? You were looking at a guy.
I didn't even put the ER on it. A fine show, by the way. I'm sorry they canceled it.
Thank you. We appreciate it. It's all because of you.
Thank you.
You know, if you weren't here, I would be home watching Jeopardy right now.
I like Jeopardy.
I do too. For 200 points, why did you buy that hat?
Oh, for this hat? I have two of them.
Do you really? Yeah. Same color?
Yes. That's good. Well, I can't find one. That's why I have two.
You know, if you got those gold things on your shoulders, you'd be like Thurston Howell the Fourth.
Now, there we're going to the video yet again. Would you be surprised? No, you saw it.
You know, one of the cool things that I've known about you is your videos, and I guess maybe not a technical kind of a question, but do you ever think about the imagery and all the stuff in your using your video takes away from the lyrics and the music of your song itself, or...
No.
Do you feel like your listeners and viewers kind of get...
Hopefully, if you did it right, it should just flow over you. Mm-hmm. You know, that's it. I hope with a new one... I do like that people would watch it over again. I like to think you can't see everything you want to see in one viewing.
One of the things I noticed with one of the videos we're going to play for you is the longer I watched it, the more I wanted a cheeseburger. And I figured you must have somehow put those screenshots in
there.
Oh,
I'm into it. Yeah, yeah.
You know.
Well, man can't live by salad alone.
Especially a salad with lamb in it. I mean,
yeah,
how many people
right.
eat salad with lamb in it?
No, I ate.
I know one.
Me and the missus had dinner with the lambs last week.
Really?
Nice, nice, yes.
How'd that
go? They're wonderful people.
Are they?
Surprisingly wonderful people.
And they're still with us?
Yeah, they were slightly offended.
You had dinner with them, you didn't have them as dinner, you're suggesting?
No.
Okay, okay, I wasn't sure about
beef.
That. Talk about some of the videos you've done. Do, re, mi, fa, la, si. What the heck
De
is
ra,
that?
De, ra, mi. De, ma, re. Oh, good Lord.
I did that on purpose.
Oh, blah, blah, blah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh, what was that? Happy, no. Merry Christmas, right?
Yeah.
Boy, see, I can remember. Fiscal, I can go back that far.
Fiscal and Ether.
Yeah, that's right. That's a long time ago. Search it on YouTube.
What Jim and I really thought about doing, quite honestly, is just forgetting this whole music thing and talking about music. We want to bring Mystery Science Theater 2000 back, and we want to be the host.
And it's coming back.
We want a little bitty robot or some kind of hand puppet that we can sit around and make fun of Mid-Ohio Rock Show videos all day long.
That's not usually what I do with a hand puppet, but that's not for now.
Talk about the video.
Yes.
One of the things I wanted to ask you about is I've got a son of mine, Dan, that plays with Aaron and Tony Chinney, a local band called the Death Rays.
Oh,
and
sweet.
One of the things that they do and love to do in their shows is they incorporate the overhead projector, the acrylic trays, the different colored oils, throw in some air, some water.
All right.
And you get this like a laugh-in backdrop that they project back behind them. But the other thing they do, which is reminiscent of your videos to me, is they have a laptop and they play all these crazy images going on with all this bubbling color effect, like the guy getting shot by the cannonball or Godzilla going up the Empire State Building. And it reminds me, when I see your videos, a lot of their band and incorporating some really cool dynamic and digital imagery within
well,
that.
Either way, in all the stuff I do, I'll give a little nod to something. Forever... 1927, Fritz Lang, director who directed Metropolis. It's epic. It's still got some of the greatest video effects of all time in it. And isn't it nice in 2017 that I'm working hard to try to copy those effects?
It's not plagiarism, is it?
Ah, no. No. Just like Siskel and Ebert, they're long. Yeah, Fritz is long gone, but a great film. If
wait a minute, just
it.
To clarify, it's Fiscal and Ether.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that would be it.
Hopefully we won't get in trouble by going that route.
I don't think so.
But yeah, just talk about your I don't want to get into your thought process, because Lord knows we don't have that kind of time, but your thoughts in kind of putting all these cool, crazy videos together.
Well, you start out maybe with a basic concept, and of course, by the time you're done, it's something completely different. Mm-hmm. You know, you do what you're, just working away the stone, taking pieces out until it kind of tells you what it wants to be, and then you better, whatever that is, you know, it's going to be. So that's how I do it, and try to go with the flow of how it feels.
So there's a process, you know, when you talk about chipping away the stone, when you chip away stone, ultimately you can't put the stone back as you would, but nonetheless.
Hopefully you made the right choices. You know, I've always like them to be a little out there, but I also like them, the main thing they're supposed to be is entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's entertaining. So if people watch them and they get like a giggle, a little bit in there, and... most of the time, there's something they're going to get out of it. You know, there's got to be some take-home on it. Something you have to get out of it that gives you a feeling that you've experienced something. So if I get that, that's enough.
Your analysis of how you're describing that, I guess, is me a little bit with music. Having spent 27 years in radio now, music has really got to grab my attention. I hear so much of it.
Yeah.
That it's like I went to the eye doctor the other day and I'm looking at 500 pair of glasses and they all looked alike. I'm like, well, that's an easy choice. It doesn't matter which one I pick because they all look the same. And music is the Whoa. Same way videos are the
you
same
just
thing.
Said that? That's your so. Metaphor toward music?
Yeah.
Oh my god, you're a DJ and you said that? Brilliant.
Whoa, I want to show
you. Oh my lord. God. Wow.
Oh, I can make a comparison to watermelons and carrots if you
that
want.
That was good.
Or lamb salad.
Salad, whatever.
Well, you know, my point is basically that there's so much out there that it all sounds the same, and you have to do something a little different. When I write commercials for people, I want them to get their attention the first moment they hear it versus halfway through. You're like, oh, that was a Blue Jean commercial? Really? I didn't know that.
Oh, right. That's exactly true.
You know, our pre-filming production meeting said that we were going to talk for 2 minutes, go to a video, talk for 2 minutes, go to a video, and here we are.
I forgot the camera's on.
8 or 9 minutes into
I know.
It.
And we haven't just gone to a video any yet. Time and put in whatever
so,
you want.
What do you say we play a video of yours?
Yeah, do we know which one? Ryan?
Everybody, I'm Tommy Barnes along with Jim Bush, and that was a video.
I'm here!
That was a video we just saw. Not sure what video we just saw, but hopefully you liked it a lot. Jim Bush put some cool stuff out. You know, Jim, that song that you did with Dayrame was written
or Dayrame, either way.
Yeah, or Thithkel and Ether.
But Ramadan.
Written back when you were like 6 years old, I guess.
It was written a long time ago. That was it. I still, you know, when I put out Dayrame, I had people that had send me letters saying that, you know, I really like that when you did it. No, I redid it. I redid it. Long time ago, I originally did it. It was bad then. It wasn't good. It's better now. Oh, I'm sorry, you just watched it. Oh, I'm sorry. We're speaking, aren't we?
They've switched the channels on.
Take that video now, make it worse. And that's what
That's what I meant.
Here's how you make it worse: you turn it back on again.
Oh, good. Yeah. No, not really. It's good for multiple viewing pleasures.
And you know, one thing that it seems like the music industry is gone is that a lot of bands aren't doing albums so much. There are doing albums, but it seems like the single is the way to go. You can YouTube it, you can get it on all kinds of social media, and it really is a better payback for you than going through the whole process of doing an album.
They're having singles jumping in the top 10 now, you know. There's good things about that, there's bad things about it, but, you know, I like it when you used to get a piece of music or a collection of songs, as they would call it, an LP, or even those newfangled CDs.
Mm-hmm.
You could put it down, let the needle drop, so to speak, and let it play all the way through. It's harder and harder to find that.
You know those songs, I call them natural-born twin spins, because you can take a song, a Led Zeppelin song, or a Journey song, and they go, when we listen to it on the vinyl album, it went from one to the other flawlessly. There was no pause. When you heard it on the radio back in the day, they'd play, you know, one Journey to the other, the Grand Funk, the different albums and different songs.
Grand Funk, get down.
Dude, man, I saw Mark Varner in 74.
You ever notice that? There's Grand Funk. Let me mention another little known band, Urge Overkill.
Absolutely.
Another really good bands, and yet critics, like, dumped on them.
Mm-hmm.
And especially with Grand Funk, you hear them all the time now, you know, in certain formatted.
Right. We're hanging out with Jim Bush here at the Mansfield Playhouse on 3rd Street in downtown Mansfield. A really cool venue. They've got the stage here. We're kind of playing Fithkel and Ether up here, reviewing some movies and some videos of Jim Bush. And you've got a new song. We actually got a chance to preview this on a screen about this big. So I can't really talk highly of it until we get it on a bigger version.
Get on that big screen.
We're going to do that for you. The song is called Forever.
You know how long it took? It was forever.
It was forever. I set the hook on that guy.
That's right.
Flight 16 in the morning, flashing light from a digital clock, you say. Yeah, you can't explain why something made you cry out my name. Should be sleeping at the time of the day. For just an instant your thoughts and my world won't end the same. Don't cry, even though you cannot see me, still I'm here. And time is not enough to feel me. Dry your tears. My love is for you
forever, my love.
My love is for you
forever, my love.
My love is for you
forever.
My love is for you. Over at the chest of the flight. That's when I found my name. 5:16, I think was the time. Don't cry, even though you cannot see me, still I'm here. And time is not enough to feel me. Dry your tears. My love is for you
forever, my love.
My love is for you
forever.
a really cool video that I recently saw. By the way, I'm Tommy, Mid-Ohio Rock Show, Jim Bush here at the Mansfield Playhouse.
Jim with Tommy.
Yeah.
Or Jimmy with
Fifth
Tommy.
Golden Ether.
That's right.
By the way, we saw your brand new video, Forever. But one of the videos I recently watched from you is called Homeward Bound. It made me think, obviously, of Paul Simon. It is such a really cool, when you think of Paul Simon's version and the way you did it, you really slowed it down, kind of methodical through it, and I just love the presentation you did with the video and the song itself. I mean, I love it more than I love you.
Now, hold on here. Oh, my God. Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm glad you brought that up.
That compliment caught up with you, didn't it, finally?
Let me bring up Tim Cummings. How's that? Tim Cummings, I think. Tom Photos. That's why I did that to begin with. That's on a CD that was released this past year. It's a lot of bands on it, and it was called Get Your Kicks. It was a compilation of songs made from the year 1966.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how that song came to be, and they actually called me up and said, would you do a song for the record? And I said, yes, I would. And that's what I came up with, and consequently did the video afterwards.
Yeah, did you grow up a big Paul Simon fan?
Yeah, and when you go back to the, you know, Simon and Garfunkel material, right. It, you know, talk about stuff washing over you. It's overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
So, but that being said, I don't want to, I'm not a cover band. You know, I don't want to do a cover band.
Well,
audition.
I think
why
that
not
would be,
put on?
I have two sons.
They're so
that,
good.
I have two sons that play, and I told them, I said, you know, if it doesn't sound like Steve Miller Fly Like an Eagle, don't do it. Make it your own.
Right.
Make it really, really good. And that would be back to my point with the song you did, Homeward Bound. It's yeah. Exactly that. We're going to probably close out the show with your version
right.
of it here. But yeah, I just thought it was really cool, and you've indicated you have to, you know, make it your own. You don't want it to sound the same, and you're not.
Well, I give due
band.
Respect to the artist.
Absolutely.
You know, hopefully I did that.
Yeah, I think you did.
Yeah, thanks.
Whether Paul does, I don't know. We could ask him.
I just sent him a letter. Now, by the way, now this is good though. Somebody picked it up out of
the trash,
Chicago.
Oh, really?
You've got to watch that. And it got picked up for licensing.
Mm-hmm.
And actually used my version for whatever, I don't know. But it does mean that I made less money off that song. But at least I know that Paul Simon's accountant knows I did the song.
Yeah.
So it would be nice if he... You know,
yeah,
somewhere around now.
You know, it reminds me back when we started Rock Show, really when we did our first episode with you, our producer Ryan Nemec had this concept with Charlie Sheen, and we played it off with Ronnie and I, with Ronnie actually going to L.A. back in the 90s with his band, Rated X. You know, kind of played off that he met Charlie. So Ryan fed us lines, and we continued to have this conversation when Charlie was going kind of crazy when he was winning. He had this Nick Nolte look about him in this video. And ultimately, we Ryan produced it, put it out on YouTube all over the world. And Ryan actually got some feedback from Charlie himself.
Awesome!
Saying, way to go, guys.
Touchdown!
Cool video, yeah.
Good job.
So, it's neat, like you're indicating with Simon's manager, his booking agent, whatever, that you get the props for something you did.
Well, it's hard telling. The thing is, it's different. You're going to think about... It makes sense to hear from Charlie Sheen, being, you know, the conservative, laid-back kind of guy that he is.
Very quiet.
Yeah. No, Paul. Paul's not. I'm not. Those calls aren't forthcoming from Mr. Simon.
Of course not. Yeah. In this case, Destiny is not a phone call away.
No, it's not.
Unless her name is Destiny.
But unless her rimshot. Thank you. But yeah, I enjoyed doing that. And like I said, there's a lot of other talent on that particular CD.
I'm curious, when they finally let you out of prison this year, what are your plans for 2017?
Well, I'll tell you, Tommy. I'm gonna
first
walk
better
the,
go see a parole officer.
Yeah, then I'm gonna walk the earth. That's right.
Show them the shoes you're gonna walk in, by the way.
Oh, really?
Yeah, with those white socks.
See?
Yeah. He's got tread on
those. Look at that. Oh.
Let's make a comparison.
Look at that, see?
Look at this.
Hey, what do you got?
I can't afford socks.
Look at
I just,
that.
You
look
know.
That. There we go. We are truly now running out of things to talk about.
I know that. Maybe we should say goodbye.
We could.
Break out, where's your
then
sound?
We're going to get some beers and watch Jaws.
It's a bull shark. It scraped me when I was taking samples.
I got something for you. That's the thresher. You see that? Chief thresher.
I got bit by a bluegill.
Thank you.
That thing had a mouth that was this big. And teeth that were like that.
That's effective. Close your eyes. You're there.
Oh, my God. Look at the fleas on his leg.
Hold on. We got to send out something. Are we sending out?
You can sign out.
Well, what see are we ya. Sending out on? Are we?
Hang on. I got to do a plug first.
Do a plug.
This episode of Mid-Ohio Rock Show brought to you by Adderall.
Adderall. Attaway.
Attaboy.
Way to go. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. What for? I'm not sure.
Ah, it was a lovely time.
Hey, I'm West Ether. Street. He's Thithgal.
Yeah, like.
You've been hanging out with us at the Mid-Ohio Rock Show. God bless you for putting up all this craziness that we've been doing. Jim Bush, amazing musician. Make sure you go check him out sometime. If you don't, it'll be okay. He'll get over it.
And remember, give to the kids.
Sitting in a railway station, got a ticket to my destination. On a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand. Every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one man band. Oh. Where my love lies waiting silently for me. Every day is an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. Yeah. And each town looks the same to me. The movies and the factories. And every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be. Oh. Where my music's playing, oh. Where my love lies waiting silently for me. Tonight I'll sing my songs again, I'll play the game and pretend. But all my words come back to me in shades of mediocrity, like emptiness and harmony. I need someone to comfort me. Oh. When the music's playing.